If you've been watching Rerez for a while, there's probably a little bit of a chance you know that I'm a big fan of retro video games. And we've covered a lot of older systems on the show in the past, but this one that we're going to show off today was sent in to us from a company named Old School, and this is called the Classic 2 HD. And it does play older video games, but it does something pretty special with them. In the past, we've shown you new video game systems that are capable of playing old video games at higher resolutions using their original cartridges. Consoles like the Retron 5, which was a console that I really liked. But one of the reasons why I chose to take a look at this system was because this one here, the Classic 2, doesn't do what the Retron 5 did. Now on the Retron 5, when you put a cartridge in, it was taking all the information from within the cartridge, saving it internally into the system for a little bit while you played the game, and then deleting that information as soon as you took the cartridge out. While the Retron 5 is a really neat system, it's not truly playing the cartridges using the internal hardware. What it's doing is it's emulating them in the same way that your home computer would emulate a game using a ROM file. But that's not what's happening with the Classic 2 HD. This is a system on a chip for the SNES and NES. It's capable of playing both systems, but unlike the emulation technologies of the Retron 5, this is actually playing it through basically a reproduction of what those original systems were like. Any game you try to run on this system should feel and look exactly the same way you would expect it to running on an NES or an SNES originally. There's certain cartridges out there that won't work with the Retron 5, like multi-game cartridges for the NES, Super Nintendo, or any other system that the Retron 5 can play. But with the Classic 2 HD, any multi-cart that you would have had on an SNES and NES working for that system should work on here as well. Because the console's capable of playing both systems and it has the controller ports at the front for both systems, they included two different controllers. One's for the SNES, and the SNES one feels really great. It's got a good D-pad, it's got fantastic buttons, and all four of the buttons on the face there are actually convex, which is kinda nice, especially if you like the original design from the Super Famicom and not the one we got in North America. But what's really cool is the NES controller is a dogbone style controller like you would have seen with the NES top loader. This is a really cool design and it feels great in the hands. My only problem with the controller is that the D-pad is a little bit squishy and the buttons are a little bit squishy as well, but honestly, that feel is so much better than what you would have seen with the original NES. But let's say you actually want something that's a little bit more NES style, Old School sells a separate controller that they also sent in to us that I thought was worth talking about. This right here is the Old School NES, and it looks exactly like an NES controller with rounded edges. This is really, really comfortable to hold, and it's got the concave buttons on the front, unlike the convex ones of the dogbone style. So if you're looking for something that feels a little bit more retro but better, this might be the one to get. Sometimes when you would play a game on the original NES, the cartridge wouldn't be read properly. And when that happened, you'd have to clean out the connector ports inside. A lot of kids used to blow into the carts, and I don't recommend that because it's not really good for the longevity of those games. But it would fix it because you're basically kind of cleaning out the area inside there. Now, this is kind of interesting because I didn't really think about this getting into the system, because it really is just the original NES or the original SNES cartridges being straight read through the system. Visual glitches can happen once in a while, and of course you can clean the cartridge and it'll be fine afterwards, but while we were playing Castlevania, we came across a glitch that visually looked unlike any other NES glitch I'd ever seen. Usually when an NES game isn't read properly, you'll see chunks of the image of the game being placed in the wrong area. It was kind of a common thing to see if the cartridges weren't cleaned. If you use a dirty cartridge in the Classic 2 HD, you get that exact same visual glitch, but you also get this weird staticky looking image here, which I've never really seen before. I know this is going to be a little weird to say this, but I'm kind of okay with seeing this kind of stuff happen with these cartridges. This is important to see because it tells you that the cartridges are actually being run the original way they should be run. Once we cleaned Castlevania with a dry Q-tip, it ran perfectly. But still, it kinda is fun to see this stuff because it's sort of nostalgic to see these little visual glitches here and there.
The system's capable of playing NES games and SNES games, but not only that, you also have a system switch on the back here where you can choose between NTSC and PAL regions, which I think is really cool, especially if you're collecting games from other regions. But something else I also like is that sometimes when you play these retro systems that play in older video games in higher definition, the aspect ratio can tend to be a little bit wrong and just not accurate. But what they've done here is on the back, you actually have the ability to switch the aspect ratio from 4:3 to 16:9. So if you're okay with your games looking all stretched and weird, you can do that. But if you're like me, you'll keep it switched on the 4:3 option so you can play the games how they were really meant to be played. We played a number of games on the Classic 2 HD to kind of see exactly how older games would perform when being upscaled to 720p, and luckily a lot of the games looked really good. I really enjoyed the performance of everything because, just like I said before, this isn't an emulation, and because of that you get a far better experience while you're playing these games. But when I say a better experience, I'm largely just talking about the gameplay, which to me is one of the most important aspects of playing these video games. If you were to play these games off an original NES or SNES, there's this very specific feel for timing that you get from those original consoles, and a lot of emulation tends to miss that out by emulating the games just a little bit quicker, and in some cases a little bit slower. But because this is realistically how the systems would have performed back in the day, the games play just like you remember them. But nowadays, we have the NES Classic and SNES Classic as new ways to play these older video games on modern televisions, and because those systems work pretty well, we wanted to compare what those systems look like compared to the Classic 2 HD. The gameplay between the systems was essentially the same, but when you compared the visuals, there was a couple of noticeable differences. For one, the Classic 2 HD had a little bit of a muted color scheme. It wasn't really so bad, but if you paid attention enough, the Classic system seemed to just be a little bit more brighter compared to the Classic 2 HD. The second thing we noticed with the system is that the image quality was just a little bit softer when you compare to the NES and SNES Classic. There are gamers out there that might prefer that softer look, but personally, I don't. I like the sharper edge of the pixels a lot more, and for me, this makes it look like that the image just isn't as high quality as it possibly could be. But when you compare the Classic 2 HD against a real NES or SNES on a high definition television, well, it's no contest. This looks a lot better, and because it's using the original cartridges, for some, that may be the difference between getting an NES Classic, an SNES Classic, or getting this one. The advantage of this system is not being limited to a bunch of pre-installed games that are already on the console when you buy it. Instead, you can go out and find a whole bunch of cartridges and play it on here without worrying about what games will work or not. I went out and picked up Stunt Race FX, and hey, it worked perfectly, actually. It felt just like you were playing it on a real SNES, and now I could play it in high definition. And sure, maybe not everybody wants to play Stunt Race FX, it's a game I don't really recommend too much, but hey, it works. And that means that you're going to be able to play a lot of hardware like multi-cartridges and stuff like that using this system, which is kind of a perk in my opinion. But because this is a modern video game system running classic video games utilizing HDMI technology on modern televisions, that means games that utilize the SuperScope won't work. But accessory plugins and stuff like that that use the original ports of the SNES, like the mouse for Mario Paint, should be fine, but there's going to be a lot of accessories out there that won't work, especially if they utilize CRT technology. So while a game like Yoshi Safari will turn on, there's really not much you can do with it if you don't have the SuperScope. And that goes the same for any NES game that utilizes the same technology as well, like Duck Hunt or Hogan's Alley. But regardless of that, the amount of games you can play on here with the NES and SNES cartridges in your collection already make it a very worthwhile system, especially if you're looking for something that can take those old games you already have and play them on your modern television. When it came to the audio performance of the Classic 2 HD, everything sounded pretty close to the original, but we did notice that the system came in very, very low. We had to turn the volume up on the TV we're using almost to the very top just to hear the games at an audible level. Not something that was crazy loud, but enough that we could all hear it in the room. It was a little bit awkward to have that problem, but at the same time, because it is a digital signal coming in through an HDMI cable, well, there's no distortion or anything, so it didn't really sound bad. It just had to be turned up louder, which was a bit weird. At the end of the day, I'm a fan of this system. I think the Classic 2 HD is worth getting, especially if you're a retro video gamer. And you know what? If you're a new gamer out there right now that wants to get into older video game systems, but you don't want to emulate the cartridges, this is probably the best way to do it and get that best experience on your modern TV. But for everyone else out there that just wants emulation, well, stick with the NES and the SNES Classic. But if you want something a little bit better and you want to be able to expand your library, this is probably the best way to do it.